What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, episode 148. It's been about four suns since I've uploaded. I've been busy with family, relaxing. Time to get back on track for the walk. Hopefully everybody enjoyed their Christmas. The new year is approaching as well in a couple of days. We have to defeat Azkall Fire Ant. Previously, I had to defeat three of the fire dinosaurs out there to collect. I forgot what. Let's look at the quest log. I know I had to collect something. Let's find these. Smoking mirror zombies. Undead compounds. I had to do about seven battles just to collect three. It was a struggle, to say the least. Let's go defeat Azkall. Yeah. It's good to be back in Azteca. Still a lot to do. Enchant that. 14,000 health. Alrighty. I was reading a lot of comments, and, yeah. I will be using my... Ooh, minus 90. There hasn't been an E3 been used on us. Yeah, it's been a while, if ever. Like, this is like the second or third time. That's unfortunate. But anyway, I'll be using my reliquary right before I hit. Made that mistake earlier. Last ep. We don't need Seder right up here. I don't think we need Myth Trap. Let's use Time of Legend. We need to find our ice wand hit. That's unfortunate. I hope he doesn't E3 again. That would be the real struggle. Really sad. Amazing. Look at that timing there, team. Okay, well, I know this for a fact. We're gonna faint him, and then we'll use the wand hit on Fire Ant. Even though he's not an ant, like, he's not an ant, but he's a dinosaur, it makes sense. Only in Aztecan terms, and in the world itself. What do we got? What are you doing? Traps? There you are. Well, we got the Fate and the Blade, essentially. Possible YOLO crit, but we don't want to rely on that. We don't really need the shield. We'll blade up. We'll wand hit, and then we'll hopefully find... Well, we gotta find Humongo Frog or something. But yeah, I'm making that mistake last time, using the other query so much. Because by the time you have it up, within those four rounds, you should normally, like, have everything killed. Essentially. Yeah. Frog? We're not finding frog. We're not finding frog. Well, I do know this. We gotta use that. Then we'll use our reliquary. I just call it the banana bubble. Let's be honest, team. The banana bubble. The roots of the banana will always be with us. I mean, our hair is yellow, you know. I've been, doing a few more things as well in, the wizard world. If we don't crit. One of them being, finding an official mog, transmog, figuring out. I think I have it down to a couple of outfits, but I'm pretty sure, almost 100% positive on one, which I will be equipping. It all depends. We gotta find frog is what we gotta find. So I'm trying to think, just finalizing it. I will tell you this, I'm not gonna have a staff, I will have a sword. The sword has been around for a while. But people don't really use it anymore, but it just makes sense. It's that connection, just like Midnight's the connection with Death and Myth. I think that's all I'll say about that. Well, if we don't find, I mean, we gotta keep that stuff up. If we don't find a frog next, we'll just have to Medusa the, minion. I don't want to, but Ivan's not being antsy enough with the spells that are popping. Wow, amazing. Right on time, my friend. Right on time. And that's the other thing. People were saying, and people have been saying, to use different spells, but, you know, you're very limited, practically as well, when you're one school. I would love to have different options to hit all, to be efficient. I could use Cyclops, I could use Troll and set up to hit, I could use other things, right, which maybe would make, maybe I could do that, but I like to do damage on the boss as well. That's my playstyle. It could get a little boring. I understand that. And I know sometimes it does, and I apologize. But I don't know. Maybe someday I'll change it up a little bit. But for right now, the frog Medusa combo I think is pretty good. But we'll have to see, Tate. But I do understand. I wish there were more options in Wiz to do, but to see about that. Seder, I just realized, when I was giving that little talk, I just realized we had 600 health. But also people have been saying, you know, get a new pet, Blue. In all actuality, changing a pet with the same stats won't make it heal more. Her hit him heal more. I've learned that the wrong way in the past. I thought it would make up. It's just the way it goes. It's all RNG based. Midnight herself, she gives excellent stats. Top tier, in my opinion, resist, fairy, and damage. What myth needs. So, we'll have to see. I don't know. For PvP, in a couple of months, we actually still are on track. You know, I think about it sometime, time and time again. You know, where are we in the spiral of, you know, where we're going? We'll be done with Azteca in January. Chrysalis will be February, going into a little bit of that. And then PvP will be, you know, 2 to 4 months or so, or 2 to 3 months, depending on when new content pops. It normally does in spring. So that's something to look forward to. And then we'll be continuing the walk on the myth, the full game solo, with, you know, help from friends, of course. You know, not everything is solo-able. And looking forward to that. So we are on track. We are. I could say that. We have one blade. Excuse me. TC faint? See if we can find that. We don't need that, do we? TC faint? There we are. It should be GG next. So yeah, we're still on track. And the way that I've, once again, like, not really analyzing, but looking, in total, Wizard, the whole walk, it will be essentially 3 days full worth of content. Like, 3 full days of hours and everything. So that's exciting. Should be GG. So, and essentially, if you would powerhouse it with friends and just go extremely, extremely fast, skip over the dialogue and do everything, you would get it done maybe in 3 days to a week, depending on how fast you went. But that would be insane, right? It's been done before, but you understand it'd be pretty crazy.
Don't tread on me!
Oscall Fire Ant scampers away, leaving the Essentia for you.
Amazing. Alright, let's go use this calendar stone, huh? What is this? What is this, team? It's like I'm a tribal master. Well, there you are. So yeah, I'm trying to think of when I should equip my official transmog. Once again, not set in stone 100%, but I'm pretty sure... I'm gonna try and go for the similar theme, if not exactly, but similar to my other Death Wizard, keeping that, people like to keep it kind of close net and relatively the same or so. So we're going along those lines. To defeat another boss, maybe? I'd have to. Who knows? We will have to see. To the boss? Again with the spooky pyramid! I'm telling ya! Alright, let's put in some more TCs. TCs. Two of those. One of those. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, we have that, don't we? I think everything's good. Midnight. Good morning to ya. Is there a boss? Oh. Something doesn't feel right, team. Getting too spooked and the music is eerie. Is that really it? Is this like an Indiana Jones style where if you, like, take the loot, it'll summon evil people or a giant boulder will fall?
You burn the undead compounds and add the essentia as Tezcat 3-star instructed you. A vision calls up from the pungent smoke. Morgant, the Shadow Queen, of course. But who is that with her? A harbinger of doom who feels eerily familiar. This dark servant's awakening causes the dead of Azteca to rise, restless and hungry.
Oh, wow. So is that the first sighting in the of Undead Malastare? From what I can recall, yes. Well, back to Tezcat. Oh, we go back to the Zocolo. Zaculu of sorts. We're moving. Bum, 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 bum. Tezcat. He's just a mystic. That's all he is, team.
You saw a vision?
Pretty prominent.
Shadow Queen, of course. At the heart of the mass of hungry dead. But she could not do it alone. This dark servant you saw her awaken in the Pyramid of the Black Sun is her conduit to the most powerful death magic. The hungry dead will not stop unless you defeat the Shadow Queen and her dark servant. Pakal has a suggestion for your next step. There is perhaps only one logical choice left for the traitor to King Axaya.
Alrighty. Easy, Tezcat, like I always say. I'll calm it down, Pakal.
I think it's safe to say that neither Toki Two-Face nor Itzko Twister Obsidian are turnscales. Both support King Axaya. So who is left? There is only one choice left. If the Storm Cayman was correct, you must confront Yacate Farwalker as a traitor. Go to Yakate's house and see what he is up to. His house is just here in the Zocalo.
Well, team, we gotta go confront this cat. Where's he at? There?
Although no one answers your knock, you hear a chilling, clicking, scratching noise from inside.
What was that sound? Oh, somebody going with us. Hello, Megan. Is she deaf? Deaf hype. I love seeing people making deaf characters, wizards.
You are looking for Yacate Farwalker? You are too slow, light child. He is already with the king, and another king will fall.
Let me just let her know what we can do here. Let's put in some more TC feints. It's kind of nice that we're... Oh, she's going in fast. Okay, one second. Hold up real quick here. Megan, I'll be right behind you. Hold on a second. need to put in a couple of these. Wherever that's at. Where are my prisms at, team? Am I going crazy? There we are. Alright, going into battle. Helping out a fellow wizard, wizardress. I don't know the correct term for that. Sorry. Malachine Moon Drinker. Well, he's like a bug, I'm good. Of course he's gonna be a traitor. Oh, she must think I'm spooky. Alright. Myth. We need to find a prism. That's what we need to find. Let's play it up. She has a scarecrow team. People remember my scarecrow. The mana gift and the pippo plenty. Those were the times. Those were the times. I'm curious of what she's gonna use. Excited though too. She doesn't have a venting fossil yet. That would be crazy good here. That'd be crazy good. Actually, I didn't even see what level she was. I think she's 80-ish, early 80s, most likely. It all depends though. Probably though. All right, blade up. Gives a lot of health. Those are my favorite things about Scarecrow. Is that he like just throws his head around and whatnot. Interesting. Taking a lot of damage. I will keep the Satyr up for her. I need this Myth Prism. Then I'll start feigning. My pips are terrible compared to hers. I think a nail. I think those drums. I think I had him right on point. Yo, that Frankenstein. Oh, she's killing the minion. She knows what she's doing. She's going ham. Dr. Frankenstein. Dr. Vaughn. Oh, she's hitting the boss. She might kill him. Well, actually, I'm actually happy she's hitting the boss. She's going to do a lot. 4,000, that's good. We can set up like a triple blade frog with a feint. Should be GG. Actually, really excited. She's thinking things practically. It's a word. Okay, remove the Satyr. Remove that. Let's faint. Well, before we faint, let's do that. And then we'll faint. She's probably gonna blade again, trying to find a spell. Perfect. The Pierce. She is pro team. What is he using? Oh yeah, it just occurred to me. He could earthquake. Oh my gosh. What am I doing? It's one of those days. No. I'm actually gonna have to heal her. I gotta see how much health she has. If it's below 2,000. No, she's still good. Death always has a little bit of extra health. A little bit more than Myth. I remember that. Alright. I'm gonna start feigning. Then I'll banana bubble. Get that amplify hype. Cannot wait till 86. I had a dream that I had sharpen. That's good though. I'm actually happy. We're not in the beginning of Azteca, but even though we are, but we're not. It's like in between. To where, how do I put it? Wait. I gotta use this first. Excuse me, team. We're in the beginning, but not really. To where sharpen 86. Early-ish on, really good, right? It will make my life easier, and it will make things fly a lot faster. Just that one spell. It may not seem to those who have never had it, but I encourage you, get to 86. Powerhouse Azteca. It can be a struggle, and it has been the entire time we've been here. the salt metal swamp. Very salty, as everybody... For people who watched the entire ep, Ponce Deggy Bone, all of that salt hype, all those myth minions, you know, there could have been any other school, right? So, going back to that, that was probably the saltiest place of Azteca. We can actually kill, I think. I do hope I can hit with these feints. That'd be really good. Oh, she's even fainting again. Is this a different type of faint? Oh, perfect. GG, Megan. She's a wizard pro. GG. Chibi GG. That went really smoothly. Block, but the boost. 8,000. Yeah, that's what it is. Blocking the crits. Not much I can do there. Oh, 10,000. That's doing it. Well, yeah. No, it would have killed on him. Thank you, Megan. Thank you. Alright, let's heal you. Gotta heal her. All of our pips. But hopefully, I think she can actually hit. If she can... I'll faint next. Oh, she's using the death trap. She might Dr. Vaughn again. She Dr. Vaughn's? GG. Should be, anyway. No problem. Did she... What? That is so unfortunate. A minus 75. Well, looks like I have to hit. But she has like a wand hit. Minus 75? Did anybody else see that? That's crazy. Your death or life. Watch out for that. That's really good. I'm curious if she has a wand hit. Oh, thank you. Midnight. Praise Midnight. Thank you. Minus 50. I'm still happy. She must not have a wand hit. Which is understandable. Normally a person should never have a wand hit of their school to take off tower shields and whatnot. It's just unfortunate. It's actually that might be the first time and or second time. Trying to think. Whoa, I'm dying over here. I want to say it's allergies, but it's winter time. I don't know what it is. It just gets to me. I apologize. I have double blade because of the dark pact. Faint with prism. Should be GG next. Power pip, thank you. Bum bum bum. It went really well. Good job, Megan. GG. Yeah, I think that's like the first time and or second time ever. Minus 75 shield. To death and life. I might have been oblivious to every other one, but it's pretty crazy.
Yes.
Well, there we are.
Ah, my defeat does not matter. My brethren will swarm over you and take you away to the shadow web, piece by piece.
Is that the first hint of Chrysalis? And or there's a shadow web in Azteca that I forgot about. Yeah, GG, Megan. GG. Pakal!
Ay, caramba. Yacate really is the traitor. He was the one who first suggested the king send troops after Tula Village, weakening our forces. Quickly, fly to the Jura Palace and deal with Yacate Farwalker. Save King Axaya Knife Moon from the Shadow Queen's minion.
Well, I think that will have to happen next time, team. Wrap things up today. So, next time we will go to the Jura Palace, defeat this cat, and hopefully move on to a new area. We've been trying to find this traitor for moons, so, wait. Do we have to defeat anybody? Let's see. Maybe not.
Please help us! Free us before the fire dooms us all!
Wait, what? Excuse me? Confused, team. Don't remember this at all. What's going on here? Somebody like... Am I missing something? Hello?
The king was taken into his private chamber by Yacate Farwalker and the Umbra Legion. We cannot reach them until the fire is out. Turn on the fountains to douse the flames!
Okay. Let's use the fountains. We'll defeat the guy next time. So the king will have to wait a little bit later, or a little bit longer, but, this is an interesting, part of Azteca. I don't really remember this. Fountain. There's a fountain over here. Well, GG.
Well done. Hurry to the private chamber and save the king. We'll keep your back out here.
Well, we'll rescue the king next time. If you've enjoyed, please leave a like. It's always appreciated. Slightly died today. I apologize. I'll see you all tomorrow. The next walk. Getting things back on track. Take care, team.